Hi, Nujin. Hi, Helen.
Hello, doctor.
Hello, Desha. Hello, Amir.
Hi, doctor.
Hi, how are you?
Doctor?
Yes.
When will be our exam?
For water supply?
Yes.
What the resources, you know?
No water supply.
You mean midterm exam?
Yes, doctor.
Let's just check it. It's in the classroom, I think, yeah?
I know in the syllabus you said between 18 to 22.
Yeah. I'm just checking. Let me check with the Hanar. And we have an Excel sheet.
Hello, doctor.
Hello.
Can you leave the live because I have an exam at 6, foundation exam.
Okay, I'm recording it and you can after that watch it, okay?
Okay, doctor, thank you, I appreciate
it. I have to do the same, sir. Thank you. I have an exam foundation.
Okay, it's okay.
Thank you,
doctor.
Sir.
I also have a foundation exam.
Okay, who else?
Esther, I yes. have also foundation exam.
Sir, I have it too.
You have
me too.
Can we go?
Yeah, yes, you can. You can leave.
Okay, thank you, sir.
You're welcome, Shaban. So we have those who are not having the exam, right?
Sir, I have an exam at 6 and.
And you and Elif?
Doctor?
Yes, Shana. Yes, Shana.
I have a foundation exam too.
So what about if we leave this class today, make it online and send you the video? So, okay. Or we will continue and we record it.
Yes,
we record it to you and send it to you. I think, yeah, let us take it and record it and send it to you. It's better, right?
Doctor, but could you please tell us the date for the exams, both the water resources and the supply?
Yeah, just let me check. Yeah, here's the Excel sheet. Here's the Excel sheet. For water supply, we have for water resources, what was that? We have a conflict. I suppose we have in water resources for 28 October. While we have for water resources, water supply, we have it at 15th of October, okay? So for water resources, we have at 15 October, at 6 to 73, okay? I will send it to you right now, okay? Hi, Anu. Mm-hmm.
Doctor, the supply on 15, but what about the resources?
The resources, it said that we have in 28. So with 28, we have a conflict, I think. There is a conflict. It's in 28 of October, we have the exam or the midterm exam of water resources.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, any updates, I will let you know. So in the we have at 28th of October the water resources, and we have for 15th of October for the water supply.
Okay, doctor.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, doctor.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yes, yes, bye bye.
Sir?
Yeah.
Yes.
What about the chapters? How many chapters included for the exams? All of them, or you skipped some of them?
About which?
All the two classes, resources and supply.
No, so for we have also 1 week. So
okay,
let's finish this chapter and we'll see, because we have also another chapter. I think it will be at to the end of this chapter will be included for water supply. Okay. Guys, let's start. I think it's late for us.
Say one more question, please.
Yes.
For our quiz tomorrow, how many chapters we should study for?
Yeah, the whole. For water resources, yeah. Because chapter one is just an introduction. Chapter two, you have all done with the assignment side. So just you have maybe just with chapter three, that's which so the what the runoff on, right? So when I said all, it means that only chapter three.
That means only chapter three we should focus.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Starting, okay, thank you very much. So let's start with the next, today's lesson. Are you ready?
Dr. Akko, one more question, please.
Okay.
Could you please send us an email in detail about the both exams, what is included, and when will be there?
For the midterms?
Yes, for the midterms.
Okay, I will announce it in the classroom, and I will make it as an assignment, you know. So there will be an assignment named as a midterm exam, and the instruction and the requirements and the details that material that is included will be written in the instruction of that assignment, and the date and the time. Okay.
Okay, thank you so much. I need to leave. I have an exam, sir. Okay.
Yeah, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, guys, so shall we start on what? Okay, let's start. Today we are going to talk about the rest of units that we have. The rest two units that we have, as we say that we have for the process that's coming after the clarifier, it's the adding some coagulant chemicals to the water, to the raw water, to try to make those particles, those solid matters that are in suspension, not self-held yet now, we add some chemicals to make them to adhere to each other, and then their masses become heavier, and then there will be settling. So the settling is coming after for the suspended coagulated, or let me say some of those adhere to each other. And we say this kind of chemicals that we have different types, and the most common one is called alum. And here's the alum. The alum is the this one, and also we are having in Slovenia the polyelectrolyte. Also, it's available in powder or solution. Now, what is the process? How to add the chemicals to the tank, and how much is the volume of the tank is required, and then after that, how to check the tanks that we need here. So then we need to have after adding the, let me say this is the clarifier that we have. After that, I will add some chemicals that we have in a tank. And this tank is called flash mixer. Flash mixer. This flash mixer is only designed to just to mix the chemicals with the raw materials that's coming, with the raw water that's coming from the clarifier. And then after that, there will be another tank, this tank just to make slow mixing. This is a slow mixing. The slow mixing tank, which is, this is just to make the flux to be collected here. And after that, when we have another tank to let this flux to be settled. Now, I can show you that that's the flash mixer, and this is this is the slow mixing tank. After I added the chemicals in a flash tank, then there will be a flow to this side, and this puddles, there is a puddles that let in the and by the way, this is going to be like this. The movement of the puddles will be perpendicular to the direction of the flow. That's Q. Now, the dimensions and the physical properties and the power that we need here, power, how much is the motor powers that we need to rotate these paddles. These paddles are required by, we have to find it and we have to know how much it will be equal. Now, let's back to the flash mixer tank. Then basically the flash mixer tank is a tank just to mix and just make the raw water that's coming from the clarifier. And we have some chemicals, so make the rotation here and send it to the flash mixer at the slow the tank. Then the duty of this tank is just to have liquefied the alum. We have one important equation that we have to know and we have to deal with, which is called G is equal to square root of P over V over mu. This is the volume of it is called a gradient velocity. Gradient velocity, it means how much meter per second per meter length of this tank will be dissipated. So it deals with the power that we have. This is the power that's needed to make this tank, this flash mixer, this we need how much power is needed to rotate only this paddles in this tank. That's one. The V is the volume of this tank. The V is the volume. V is the volume of the tank. And by the way, we have viscosity, the liquid that are here in this tank, which is water. We need to know how much is the viscosity of water. Then after that, we will get the P over V over mu. And then the gradient velocity, it's in terms of 1 second, P will be in watt. And V in will be in meter cube, and viscosity it will be in Newton meter per second, Newton meter per second square. This is the common equation that's used to design the flash mixer and flash mixing tank. Here's the units, and by the way, we have due to the experiences and the design common factors that we have. We should use at least more than two tanks. This is the first. And the second thing that we have to have it is the common value of the G, the hydraulic, the gradient velocity in this tanks. We have a range. The range is it's equal to 500 to 1000 per second, 1/s. As much as you have more gradient, it means that we have more the rapid mixer there will be in this tank. Also, we have dimensions of this tank that's used for flash mixing. It's by the way, we can use squares like this, and sometimes its width or its depth should not be more than 4 meters, because we don't want to have a very deep tank. We want to have just for mixing. That's only that was for the that was only for the flash mixing, and also we have for we have for the slow mixing time. Also, we have another recommendation or another, and it's also the same equation will be governed. How much is the power that's required to just? By the way, the slow mixer, we have this kind of bottles. Okay, this one, this is will be look like this. So there will be a rotation. There will be a rotation of these bottles around this axis. This is called a paddle. And there is a paddles. The paddles, we have blades and we have paddles. So how much is the rotation? And this is will be rotated in the about this axis. So how much RPM, a revolution per minute is required. It's a function of the power that's needed. But here we have a different thing. If we had the value of G in this slow mixer tank, here's the slow mixer tank. So it will be look like this. And this is also the same. We have flow in this tank in this way. We have to know that this is a slow mixing tank. So the slow mixing tank that we have, it has a value of G or gradient velocity in lower values. Lower values, it means in between 10 to 80 per second. So remember that we have two types of tanks, flash mixers or slow mixers. For the flash mixers, we have the value of G is about 500 to 1000 per second. And for the slow for the slow mixers, we have the value of G, the gradient velocity is between 10 to 80 per second. This is one. Also, we have time. The time needed for this to have the detention time of in this tanks, it should be between 30 seconds to 60 seconds. It means that you are not allowed to have to set to store the water for more than 1 minute. We need is a very flash. It's a very flash mixing. While in the slow mixing, we need to have a tank for 20 to 30 minutes, half an hour. It's slowly held the mixing in this tank. That's what we have it in the tank and in the flash mixer. And in the slow mixer time. One more thing that also we have a relation between the power that we will get it, we need it for this tank, and also the rotation of, because usually this is will be in the paddles and the paddles need rotational per minute. There is the power that's here in this equation. It will be as a function and as a term of the area of the plates. Like, look at this one. Yeah, this area. This area, this is area of the paddles. So this is a function of this one. So as much as you have less area, it means you need less power to rotate this axis. And for this reason, we have a formula. The formula is say that then the power that's needed to rotate this axis is equal to C sub D, which is the coefficient of discharge times, or drag coefficient, sorry, drag coefficient is the coefficient that's there, that's not, let me say, it's acting against rotating the power, times the raw water, well that's what we know, that's it's 1,000 kilogram per meter cube, and raw water times the summation of area, times VD cube over 2. So summation of area, it means how much is the total area of the paddles that we have. For example, for this one, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So the area of those four paddles plus, we have another four here, 1, 2, 3, 4, plus another area, another four area, and another four area. Now we have all the areas. So that's called the summation of area that we have. Summation of area that we have times the velocity of each of them. The velocity that we have, which is called diving velocity. Diving velocity and paddle velocity, we have two types of velocity. When we have a paddles like this, and this is a paddle that's, we need to move it, then yeah, there will be look like this. They are connected to each other. So when I want to move this paddle like this, there will be a linear velocity and rotational velocity. Usually we will have rotational velocity, which is RPM that we have. And this rotational velocity can be changed to the velocity that we have in linear. So a linear V paddle, linear velocity. Linear velocity, it means meter per second, while the RPM is the revolution per minute. How much is that paddles will rotate up per minute. Now VTP, which is the velocity of the paddle that we have, how much is per 1 meter, we have the velocity that we have rotation per minute that we have times. In each minute, there will be one rotation. The rotation, it means how much is the circumference of that circle that will be consistent. So if I have the depth, the diameter of this circulation, of this rotation, I can say in each minute, there will be a rotation. And each rotation will be equal to pi circumference, pi diameter of this one. Then this is come after the, it will give you a velocity, linear velocity, which is equal to velocity of paddles, which is equal to pi d over RPM times the pi d, revolution per minute, and divided by, I should move it in, make it in meter per second. So how much is the rotational I have per minute, and how much is the per minute rotation there will be in diameter. This is give you a VP, which is the, it's called the paddle velocity. The paddle velocity, as I said, it's equal to the velocity of the paddles that we have it, and this is the velocity of the paddles that we have it. Then this is will be the velocity, and this is will be the velocity. Now, this is VP. This is true. This is true when we have RPM. We said that the velocity of the paddles linear, this is linear velocity, is equal to how much rotation per minute, per minute that we have, times in each minute the rotation, it will be how much, this is the diameter or the distance of the rotation, so times pi d, that will give you in linear velocity that we have. But this is true only when we have this is true when we have the paddles outside the water. When we have the paddles inside water, I diving in the water, there will, this velocity become less than the real one. How much it will become? It will, there will be losses. The losses, it's range between 0.7 to 0.8% of the real one. So the real velocity, which is called V diving or diving velocity, is equal to about 0.70 to 0.80 times this velocity of paddle that I have. Now, back to the equation, or back to the what we have here, because this, the power is a function of the diving velocity, power 3. By the way, this is V sub D power 3. So the equation is the power that's needed for rotating all the power the power is needed to move this paddles, this paddles like this VD is equal to 1/2 C sub D drag force times rho water times summation A area of, which here's the area of all the paddles that we have. So this is A summation area times V sub D cube. Here's V sub D cube, and V sub D is equal to V sub D is equal to V sub B times 0.7 to 0.80%. And we know that V sub paddles is equal to rotation per minute times pi times D. And here's the D, the center to the center of the paddles that I have. Hello?
Yes.
Is it clear?
Yes, but the numbers are different in the one you uploaded. For example,
which one?
It says the mixing time for the flash mixer is 30 to 120 seconds. So which one do you need?
For the flash mixer, you said 13 years there.
Is it 30 to 120 or 30 to 60 seconds?
The mixing time, this is for the flash mixing. The flash mixing, we have 5 to, this is the time of the mixing. You mean the G value? The G value is between 500 to 1000 per second. This is what I have. I don't know what are you. And here's okay. This is okay. V sub V is equal to pi times D times RPM. And here's the dive. Yeah, I think you mean this one. This is for the slow mixing tank. For the slow mixing tank, we have to have times between 20 to 60. And the G is between 10 to 80 seconds. It should not be more than 60. Usually it's between 10 to 60 per second. Sorry, I'm 10 to 80, it's correct, not wrong. The area of the paddles, here's something else I didn't mention it to you. Here's a tank, the slow mixing tank, and I will put, look like this is the tank and this is the queue that I have, and this queue will help us to mix the flow of water that we have it here in this tank, right? It will be moved, it will be rotated. So the rotation, it will be look like this. And if I want to know, this is the width of the tank and this is the depth of the tank, right? H. Now the width times the edge is equal to the area. Which area? The cross-sectional area that we have it. Now with the area of the paddles, the summation area of the paddles that we have, AC, this is the summation area of the paddles. I say that usually this area, the summation area of paddles, it should not be more than, it's between 10 to 30% of the total area of the cross-sectional area that I have. Why this happened? Why I am required to have, let me say this is a level of water, and this is the water. This is the paddles that we have. So this two area, this is give you the summation of area. And while we have the total area, the cross-sectional area we have is the W times H. Say that W times H should not be, this summation area should not be more than 30% of the total area. This is for not making the flow closed, or let me say the flow, the water is go fluency between the puddles. We need water to go in a laminar way, in a certain way that's not, yeah, look at the blue one. The blue one is the one that I mean. the water will should be go past between the puddles in a way that's not there will not be obstacles to that flow. That's what I mean. That should not be more than 30%. Okay, guys, so I think it's clear to you. We have two examples. I want you just to have a look on this one. It's example one and example two. I want to solve one of them. And I think there is only time for solving one of the examples. Now, in this example, we have, remember that we have only one equation, which is say that the G value is equal to power divided by volume of the tank divided by mu. There is a tank required power of mechanical rapid mix tank. This is very important. We have to know that the rapid mix tank that we have, we need to design this rapid mix tank to treat Q. How much is the Q is there? Q is equal to 300 meter cube per hour. Now, assume temperature of 20 degrees Celsius, and we have the value of G. The G is the gradient velocity. We say the gradient velocity is usually be between 500 to 1000, and in this example, we have 160 per second. Now, it needs from us to find the required power. So what's the required? The request to find the power and also find the tank dimension, circular one. We want to have how much is the dimensions of the tanks. Assuming that we have a circular tank, the tank is having a diameter and having an edge. So give me the dimension of this tank that will help us to make this calculation or this calculation. Now, based on what we will have from the table, at 20 degrees Celsius, we need the viscosity of water at 20 degrees Celsius. At 20 degrees Celsius, the viscosity, dynamic viscosity of water, it will be equal to, it's equal to 1.0087 times 10 to the power minus 3. 1.0087, it's 1.0087 times 10 to the power minus 3 Newton meter per second square. So what's required? It was required to find the P. For this one, we need something. We need to assume at least this is a flash mixing tank and we have a range for having a time. Let me say if I have the time consumption or detention time for this tank is between, we said between 5 seconds to 60 seconds. It means about 1 minute. 1 minute is the only one you have to maintain the water in this tank. So, okay, we have, if I assume the maximum detention time is equal to 1 minute, then I want to know how much is the volume of the tank that we have it that's required to be treated within 1 minute. Now, volume is equal to Q times time, which is equal to the Q of the tank is equal to 300 meter cube per hour times time. The time is 1 minute. And I want to convert 1 hour also. 1 hour is equal to 24. 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. So that's why I have the total volume of this tank is equal to 300 divided by 60. It means that we have about 50 meter cube. this is the volume of the tank that will be a flocculation tank or coagulation tank for it. Now, the steps of the design is, first of all, you have to assume a time, the time detention between 55 seconds to 60 seconds, it means 1 minute. And also, now we have the volume, and here's the volume, and we have the value of G. The value of G, and we have the viscosity, so it's easy to find the P. Now we say that G is equal to P over volume mu and the square root, and it's given to us that the viscosity, or that the gradient velocity, is equal to 600 per second. So I have 600 per second will equal to the square root of the P, which I'm looking for, divided by 50 multiplied by 1.0087 times 10 to the power minus 3. So I have one equation with one unknown. From this one, I get the power, and you can find the power through using this equation. And I can say 600 square times 50 times 1.0087 now the power is equal about 18,000 156.6 watt, or we can say it's about 18.156 kilowatt. This is the kilowatt that's required for moving or having this flash mixer. Now, what about the dimension of the tank? The dimension of the tank, it will be easy. We have volume of the tank. The volume of the tank is equal to 50 meters square. So we have the volume of the tank is equal to 50 meter cube. It's circular. Circular, it means that we have the area times the edge. This is the area times the edge, and the edge is the depth of water. You can, and also, area is equal to pi d square over 4, and the edge we have. There is, they say that assume the edge is equal to 1/2 of the diameter. So a volume of the tank is equal to edge, which is 1.5 times the diameter times the area, which is equal to pi d square over 4. It should equal only to 50. And then from this equation, we can get the value of D is equal to 4 times 50 divided by 1.5 divided by 3.14. We'll get you and take the square root. It's about 6.5 meter, I think. You can check this one in the your homework as home. So check this one, and here's the, I'm sorry, this is wrong, totally wrong. Again, this is wrong. I think 6.5 is too much. There's a miscalculation. Yes, 1.5, we have 1.5 times pi divided by 4 is equal times 50 is equal, and take the power of 1/3 I think the diameter is about 3.89 meter. Use diameter equal to 4 meter. So diameter of the tank is equal 4 meter, and the head of it will be 1.4 times 1.5. It means about h equal to 6 meter. I want you to check these dimensions and follow the design steps.
I got the same numbers.
I think, yeah, sorry.
I have the same numbers for the diameter and.
Yeah, I had a
mistake. The height is 2, I guess.
2?
Yeah.
The height will be h, and h is equal to 1.5 times the diameter. It means 1.5 times 4, it means 6 meter. Right? I think
isn't
it was...
Isn't the height half of the diameter?
One half. 1.5 of the diameter. It's not 0.5. One and a half.
I got it.
Guys, I think it's the time we cannot start with the second example, but is it you got the idea of the flash mixing tank, how to use this equation? Do you have any question regarding this? Okay, I will send the recording for this one, yes. No question? Okay, I will try to record the solution for the second example also and send it to you to be, do you have the exam for tomorrow also? Tomorrow is Friday, right?
Yes, doctor, we have just the quiz for the resources.
For the resources. So it will be easy, just only one question at 11 and we'll need only a 15 minutes and that will be enough, okay?
Okay, doctor.
Okay, take care and have a nice rest of the day have a nice weekend for this.
Thank you, doctor, have a good day.
Bye-bye, Noor.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, bye.
Thank you, doctor, have a good day.
Have a nice day.
Goodbye, sir.
Bye-bye, Surya.
Goodbye, sir.
Bye-bye.